And I want to know, you know, I've seen that you have a big following on Facebook. I've seen that, you know, people know who you are. I want to know what you can bring to the table, man. So why do you think you could be the next Tom?
Hey, I don't know if I can replace Tom, but I think I could do a fairly good job.
Well, he's a lot easier to replace than you think, to be honest with you. He's not...
No, I like Tom, but yeah. I got to tell you, I go, you know, I have a pulse on the... Right. Community, I think I'd be good for it.
Okay, listen, I'm going to test you out with some of these things right now. First off, Tom is very rough on de Blasio. That's what he brings to the table when we're there. He says a lot of funny things, animated things. Give your one animated line to de Blasio. He messes something up like he always does. What's your one animated line? What's your catchphrase? Tom's is, are you kidding me? What's your catchphrase to de Blasio when he messes something up?
Grab a glove and get in the game.
Grab a glove and get in the game. Okay, next one. I need to see your head nod. Tom gets a head nod when we start every show. The camera turns to him. This is the shtick. Hey, guys, Shane DeMille, it's down. It's alongside me, Tom Robleski, senior opinion writer. And he goes, so I'm going to introduce you now. You give the head nod into the camera, nice and serious. A little smirk. If you want to add a smirk, we'll see how that goes. Ready? Hey guys, Shane DeMille with the Staten Island Advance. Alongside me, Michael Riley, ex-NYPD sergeant here on Staten Island. That's a nod. Wait, we got the nod? Is it coming up on the thing?
Perfect.
All right, last question. I got to replay that later because I couldn't see it now. Last question. So how do you feel about me as a co-host? How do you feel? Your feelings about me in general? I'm just curious.
I like what you do. I've seen it. I watch it. My brother thinks it's great. He right, loves it.
Good.
So,
good.
You know, it's a good job. I like it.
All right, more. What else is good about me?
Listen, it's all about the community. That's
right.
What you got to remember.
All right, this guy's got the right answer. Tom, you're on thin ice, pal. Take another two vacations. I don't know if you're going to be coming back.
But let's go Mets.
Are they? You like the hat? You like Tom's hat? Okay.
Yeah, I'm a Mets fan, too. So.
Formerly, guys, Shane DeMille with the Staten Island Advance. Alongside me, Michael Riley, ex-NYPD sergeant on Staten Island, reporting for you on Facebook. And this is a Hot Minute live from the, Outer Bridge here, guys. And Tom is on vacation. We have Mike joining us here today. First off, Mike, for some people who don't know, who are you? What do you do? Why do so many people know about you, especially on Facebook?
Well, I mean, first, I gotta go a little non-serious. You demoted me, man. I'm a lieutenant.
Oh, I'm sorry. He said sergeant. Mark, set me up. I'm only kidding.
Right now, I have the highest rank. I'm Mr.
Okay.
Because
you could have left that out
so
there, Mark.
Good.
Thanks, appreciate that. Jesus.
But honestly, I mean, what I do is, you know, I'm president of the Community Education Council, District 31, which is all of Staten Island.
Yep.
I put out community alerts, some information on Facebook. You know, it's kind of just giving back to my community. I mean, that's what I try and do. However I can help. And I tell everybody this all the time. It's not about me. It's about me just helping the community.
Right.
And you know what? I do my little part. I may not have the answer, but I'll reach out to somebody that I think that I can get the answer from, and hopefully it works out for the best.
So if you guys are joining us right now, again, Michael Riley joining us right now, the highest ranked in the NYPD before he left. Thanks, Mark Stein.
Sorry.
We got Mark Stein driving.
Oh,
we got Steve Zaff producing. We got the video going live right now. We're going to do it for the next 20 minutes or so while we drive around Perth Amboy because of Mike's video. Also, make sure you hit the thumbs up button, the more live videos we could do, and hit the share button in the bottom left corner. We got your comments. I'm looking at them live right now. I'm going to read them to Mike. If you have any questions for Mike, Staten Island stuff, NYPD stuff, issues, put him here and I'll put him on the spot. Let's see how he handles it. I mean, he's got to be Tom, right? So let's see if he can do it. I think he'll do fine. Tom doesn't do too much. It's all right. It's not a problem. So some of the questions we got. Mike Riley is the best, says Michelle. Mike Riley is the best. Thank you for your service, Michael Riley, says Raisa. You're an amazing guy, says Marie. Thank you for everything you do, Mike. So a lot of people saying that they love you out here, Mike. What do you say to your fans out here?
Well, I'm flattered, and you know, it's something that I take pride in trying to help. And you know what? If you ask my wife, though, I'm sure it gets in the way sometimes. But she's very supportive, and she's been great. I'm just happy to give back.
So speaking of your wife and child, you're driving back the other day, Sunday night, from Perth Amboy, trying to come back to Staten Island. We know Staten Island traffic is crazy, but this is a little different. This is from Jersey into Staten Island from the Outer Bridge. Mike put a video up on his Facebook page, 20,000 views. What exactly was going on that night, man?
Well, I started, believe it or not, I was visiting my sister-in-law and my nephews and my newborn niece in Sayreville. And all of a sudden, I started getting messages on Facebook, either tagged or private messages, and they were, you know, telling me about the traffic. So I started to give a little bit of updates, and then we had to leave. So I got on the road, heading back on Route 35, and we're going across, and all of a sudden we see streets closed down. People let me know about it too up front, that some of the streets were closed. And it, what a trip that generally takes us 20, 25 minutes at most. Well, when I drive,
right.
My wife may get there in
15. I could do it in about 6.
Yeah, my wife may get there in 15, but just kidding. but, you know, it took us an hour and 15 minutes.
Damn, man.
And, you know, it got to the point where we saw, you know, a tsunami of red lights, like I said. And it's something that is more about infrastructure, I think, getting to the outer bridge. Because, you know, you have all these lanes that are merging into just two lanes onto the outer bridge.
Right.
So, you know, and I feel for the people of Perth Amboy, you know, that's got to be so troubling on those side streets when you get so much traffic.
Right.
And, you know, my wife joked around because as we were driving and we saw it, there's a sign on one of the streets and it says, light traffic only.
Light traffic
and
only,
it was, I wish she would have been able to get a picture of it. It would have been funny.
That would have been nice.
You know, but, you know, it's... But when you got down towards the mouth of the bridge, towards the entrance on State Street, you saw that Perth Amboy police were there blocking the streets, but they weren't assisting in getting the... So, you know, I'm sure it was overwhelming for them, you know, being, you know, working in the police department. I understand when there are sometimes when you start to try and direct traffic, it sometimes makes it worse because there's just so much volume.
Yeah.
So they really need to do something about it. And, you know, I joked around yesterday posting that airplane that landed in on the highway Long Island.
Nice video.
And I go, well, some of us, you know, coming back to Staten Island on Sunday night could have used that airplane.
Yeah, that's the
and, you know, I was able to joke about it because,
right.
You know, nobody got hurt.
Yeah, exactly.
And it was pretty funny at the end of that video that the police officer looks like he's
pulling over the plane.
Yeah, it was pretty funny.
I've seen that.
But
what kind of ticket can you get for that? I'm curious.
Believe it or not, there is a law on the books that if you land a helicopter without notifying somebody or a plane, you can get a summons in New York City.
I learned that on my drone test, studying for my drone test. I learned that,
pretty
actually.
Pretty funny.
If you're joining us right now, guys, Michael Riley here, joining us here on a Hot Minute Time. He's out, all right? Maybe permanently. He's out. He's taking too many vacations. The guy doesn't work a day in his life. And we are doing a Hot Minute Live in Perth Amboy. Mike posted the video of all that traffic coming back on Sunday night. 20,000 views. Check it out on his Facebook page. Michael Riley, Mike Riley on Facebook.
Michael Riley
on Facebook. So we're just talking about some other issues, you know, specifically the traffic. So the ways that you think, what are best to alleviate? And again, if you guys are watching right now, put your comments in the comment section below. How often do you face crazy, hellish traffic, especially Sundays coming back to Staten Island? What do you guys think that are watching right now? What do you think could be done to resolve this? And any other questions you have for Mike? So what do you think is the solution, Mike, mostly? The solution is what? Helping merge this traffic, helping open up other ways to get around to Staten Island? What do you think?
Well, long term, we need another outer bridge. We need a larger bridge, maybe build a sister bridge. You know, something that will open up maybe 3 or 4 lanes each way. You know, I don't know if that's feasible. I'm sure the studies will be done. I think the borough president put something out today saying that within the next 10 one of the major issues on the outer bridge, and listen, we're never going to get rid of all that traffic because the summer beach traffic is always going to be there.
Right.
But one of the problems that we always have are the people cutting through on that shoulder as you ride up to the outer bridge.
Right.
You know, it's the typical nobody else matters but me.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know?
That's
one of the problems, right? I have to say, though, during my escapade getting back Sunday night, I was very impressed that there was minimal horn honking.
Okay, wow.
And
impressive.
I did not once, I did not once see any real people get angry, yelling out the window, nothing. I mean, it was something that, you know, I have to say, for the experience that they were going through, it seemed pretty safe.
Everyone was peacefully suffering together, is what you're saying, right?
Yeah. Okay. I mean, listen.
They accepted their fate. And
I mean, if we had a George Foreman grill, maybe we could have made some food or something, you know?
Don't you wish it would have been like this? Look at this open area nice we got going on. Nice Thursday afternoon doing a hot minute, guys. This is a live hot minute with Mike Riley, the highest ranking possible in the NYPD. Shout out Mark Stein for that information. Thank you so much. He's here joining us. He's got a great following. So now how many people follow you on Facebook, Mike? Let's talk about how you get your information out. How many people are on Facebook, and what exactly do you do on your page?
I have, right now, I'm up to about 30,000 followers.
30,000.
You know, people have asked me, you know, why don't you make it into a like page, but then I lose all my information that I have.
Okay.
Because I have a lot of things that I've saved, notes and things like that, pictures that I'll reshare about information. So what happened when I hit the limit of 5,000 friends probably 3 or 4 years ago.
Okay.
And when I did hit that limit, I was able to get a follower button.
Wow.
So now, as soon as you send me a friend request, you become a follower.
Wow.
And don't get me wrong, I'm sure some of those 30,000 followers are not Staten Islanders. They may not even be real people.
Right.
But I'm very cautious about what I post, and I post my own personal information. Generally, sometimes I'll post some pictures of my family.
Right.
Very, very infrequently. So the stuff that I do share is basically just to get the word out to the community. You know, I try and be positive. I try and share, like, the good things. But sometimes, you know, we have no choice that there's alerts that you want to put out about some dangerous stuff.
Right.
But most of my stuff is mostly traffic, some crime alerts, you know, breaking into the cars, leaving. You know, one thing I will ask is please.
Car doors, like, come on, like, that's a.
You know why?
Why?
I'll tell you why. I forgot. Seriously?
Yeah, exactly.
I know, but you know what?
Right.
I owned it. I posted about it, and I said, look, it happens to everyone.
Right.
Just try and remember.
Yeah, you got to remind people. I mean, it happens. Like you said, stuck in the moment with the kids. I mean, kids are like the worst distractors of any responsibility.
On this trip back to Staten Island, so it wasn't as treacherous. Screaming. To watch something.
Pick up the stuff.
You know?
We got a lot of questions coming, a lot of people asking for some stuff right now. I want to give you. How about that? Michael Riley from Mayor.
Well, I mean, listen, in reality, you know, I may be known. An enormous group that you know a few years back I did a write-in campaign for mayor. You know, but when I did that as the write-in campaign, it was about getting the issues heard,
talking about
the issues, you know, and that's what we have to do, you know, and listen, I have to be honest. I'm a Nicole Malliotakis supporter, and I think she would be a fabulous mayor. And I think she's hitting all the right points right now.
Right.
She's talking about it. She's talking about the transit, the trash, the homelessness, all those things. And these are some of the things that, unfortunately, we see things falling to the side with Mayor de Blasio. And you know, it's all about quality of life.
Right.
And many of these quality of life crimes are set because of the tone that he put out. And this was for the past several years.
Right.
And that tone needs to be stepped back. And we need to make sure that, you know, we create a compassionate yet proactive approach to ensuring we have a good quality of life everywhere in the city.
I have an option. First option is, Mark, you might need to pull over to get service because people keep saying the video's stopping.
Oh, really?
Which sucks. So maybe stop to recalibrate real quick, pull over. And I got an option, though. How about, forget, listen, support whoever you want, all right? How about you go for the mayor, put me on your ticket, I bring my Snapchat following. You bring your Facebook following. We put this together and we take over the city.
You know, I will need a press secretary. Yeah.
Oh, so. Press! I just got demoted. It was because it was a sergeant. I said it was a sergeant.
It's
all, well, back
that's right. It could have been worse. I could have said deputy press secretary.
Okay, listen. I'll take it. If you guys,
deputy mayor of press. All right.
Let's see where this is going, guys. If you're joining us right now, Shane DeMann for the Staten Island Advance, alongside me, Michael Riley, the highest ranking NYPD official possible when he retired. He's posted a lot of stuff on Facebook every day with updates for you guys, especially Staten Islanders, trying to get some of the news out. It's similar to what we do, but he does it in his own cool, creative way. 30,000 followers, people checking it out all the time. We got a lot of people going down right now. Another one, Diana, he is awesome. Thanks for all you do, Mike. Video keeps stopping. Get some service. We agree with you. It looks a little smoother now, actually. So we're trying to pick this back up. Diane gives you a shout out as well. Hi, Michael, says Kathy Riley Peep. Mike is
my cousin.
There you go. See, she's watching. What do you want to say to your cousin? Give a shout out to your cousin.
Cuz, how you doing? Hope all is well.
Mike is the best, Tony Whitaker says. Too many cars on Staten Island, says Janice. Is that a problem?
Yes. I mean, if you think about it, there was a report that came out. It was Staten Island 2030. I think they did this whole recap. It was the Staten Island development, right?
Yeah.
And that report came out, I think, in 2011, maybe, mm-hmm. 2012. And when you look at that stuff and those reports and the IBO and all these reports, if you look at how many registered vehicles we have on Staten Island, most families have 3-4 cars.
Damn.
And, you know, you're talking about 480,000 people.
Yeah.
Not everybody, of course, has that many cars.
Yeah.
But, so you're looking at, we represent 2% of, right? 2% or 6% of New York City's population.
I'm not a numbers guy, Mike. Right? I'm like not that. Good with the math. That's why I got into this.
I think we represent 2% of New York City's population,
okay.
But yet we have 6% of New York City's registered vehicles.
Okay, well, that makes sense. It's a little too many cars.
Yeah.
It's a little too many cars.
So when you think about the traffic that's coming into Staten Island, and you know what? Perth Amboy and some of the residents there, I saw they were posting on my video, you know, saying Staten Islanders stay home, but they don't realize that some of those commuters were not Staten Islanders.
Right,
they're going back
right.
to Brooklyn. They're going back to Queens. Wherever they're coming from for visiting their family, they moved to New Jersey. And, you know, that if you look at the infrastructure of the bridges, all three of our Port Authority bridges, they were not made for that many cars.
Yeah.
And that's the bottom line.
A lot of people agreeing with you about a sister bridge or a smaller bridge or something else to get people the hell off the island. You gotta help people go back and forth. Also, guys, we keep breaking up with the video. So, Mark, I don't know if you want to head just towards the bridge and start going back, but going through the neighborhoods, it ain't working. It ain't working for the video. So, thank you, Mike, says Janice Russo Cipriano. See, I'm bad with names. That's Cipriano, right?
Janice
Russo.
Yes.
Thank you, Mike. Someone says, let's read it. Lyle, time to move for me. That's how bad traffic is getting. Time to move. You hear a lot of people saying that. You know, I can't drive around. I'm getting off this island, you know, something like that. That's how bad traffic. It's so bad you want to move. That's rough.
Well, you got to remember that. I just spoke about quality of life, right? When you hit so much traffic every day and you're on that slow crawl, whether it's going over Snake Hill, whether it's going Highland Boulevard, whether it's going Richmond Avenue by the mall, because we got one car that's stalled. This is quality of life for people.
Yeah.
So it's taking them 2-3 hours sometimes to get around.
Right.
You know, and that's one of the major concerns that people have. And this is something that we need to address.
Peter Botros, what's up, man? Thanks for the shout out. I appreciate it. Guys, if you're watching the video right now and it's stalling, don't leave yet. We're about to be on the bridge. Keep hitting that thumbs up button. The more live videos we can do, the more thumbs up we get. Also, hit that share button in the bottom left corner. Share this video, especially if you know Mike Riley here, who's always trying to report and bring information to you guys on his Facebook page with around 30,000 followers. Thanks, Mike and Shane, says Kathy. We're at this together. This is no more Tom. He's out. He's gone. This is the new guy for the next 2 weeks until Tom comes back and tries to threaten me. This is the best we can do.
I'm keeping your seat warm.
Brian says, what's with the girl's sunglasses? Well, I got it for $5, actually, in a store, and they're nice and thin, if you could see that right there. So they're light on my face. I don't like a heavy sunglasses, all right? So you get off my back about it. Keep up the great work, Mike. Keeping the public informed, helping us all at the same time, says Mary. There you go. A lot of shout-outs here from Mike. A lot of people seem to, you know what you're doing that are here watching right now, love what you do. And when did this start about again? You mentioned it before. Let's bring it back in. When did you start posting on Facebook, and when did it start? Like, was there one post that blew it up for you that really you were like, wow, I got 100, 200, 300, you know?
Yeah, well, believe it or not, it all started back my 20th high school reunion. A couple of friends asked me to join and help put together the reunion. I did that, and after everything was done, I said, what can I do with this? So I was bored one day, and I decided to post a traffic alert.
Right.
And then all of a sudden, it started taking off. One of the things that really put it over the top, where I started getting a lot of shares and followers and stuff, was when I posted about the bus lanes.
Okay.
When they were first rolling out, and I posted where the cameras were for the bus lanes. I had all the locations for the cameras,
right?
And then of course then the speed cameras by the schools.
Yeah.
So these were all things that I started to share and talk about and let people know about the legislation that was being presented, because that was the main thing, and I wanted people to know what was going on.
Right.
And those things took off, and I think that's why the following started. And then just sharing information, you know, because it's not me.
Yeah.
It's just what I can do to help others, right. And that's what it's about.
So the day-to-day grind is more just you, whatever comes your way, and you're sharing, getting it out to people, especially on Staten Island, right? That's usually the way. Just daily updates is pretty much what
you're doing. Pretty much.
If you guys are joining us right now and the video is not buffering, good, but it is on mine right now. Shane Duhamel with Staten Island Invasion, alongside me, Mike Riley, the highest-ranking NYPD official before he left the force, retired now, lives on Staten Island, and helps you out with updates, gets you out sometimes quicker than we can even get it to you. Check it out on his Facebook page. It's Michael Riley. You don't have to check it. You're fighting for the check. You want the check. The blue Facebook confirmed check. You need
Facebook won't give it to me.
He wants it. He's here, though. He's real. He's real, guys. I'm verifying for you that he's here right now. I think we might end the video. If there's anything else you want to touch on, Mike, we spoke about the traffic mostly. We just drove through Perth Amboy in New Jersey. It's clear now. This might keep happening on Sundays and other nights, but anything else that you want to address to people that are watching here on the Staten Island Advance Facebook?
One thing that I really want to put out there is, you know what? We always hear about the negatives. Let's talk about the positives. Let's show what Staten Island's good for. And we know there are a lot of good things out there. There's a lot of organizations that are helping. There's a lot of people that want to help. And you know what? Let's share positive. I mean, granted, there's always going to be some negative stuff, but if we could show some positive just to counteract it, because I guarantee you there's a lot of good out there.
Beautiful message, man. Tom would never say something like that. That's so positive. That's such a great... Mike, thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks,
I appreciate it, guys.
Thanks.
Staten Island Advance. That was a hot minute. Tom ain't going to be here for a week, so I'll find someone else. Hopefully, Mike, again. Thanks for watching, guys.